Well, I should have my other camera with me. Big heavy duty helicopters, but they're way too high to video. It's a pretty day out here today, but it's cold. I heard them helicopters whopping and thought I'd come out here and video, but you ain't gonna get them with a GoPro. Too nippy to be out here in my jammies. So I went back and got dressed. Got my Yeti Gobber picker upper. I need to rebuild this deck. It's getting too old. I thought we'd take a look at my grill, even though I'm not going to move it today. Make sure I ain't talking through my hat about the possibility of using this for a Ford. You don't use it as a grill anymore. Okay. My notion was to just use this as a table or a stand. We can strip all the guts out of it. I considered using it as a propane forge, but I like the idea of just using a blower and coal or coke, charcoal, some other products. Well, I can't pick it up with that. I guess I just have to get my fingers nasty. And do it the old-fashioned way. See, all the stuff rotted out in there. I can take all that out. That metal's a little on the thin side, but we could get some 1/8 inch plating, 1/4 inch plating, and do a recess, drop it in right here, and build my own. Or I could just build a frame and put a large truck brake drum in there. Maybe surround it with a table here where I could put my coke. I like that idea. That's just tin there, but it would block the wind okay. The top itself, I don't know if I'd remove the top. I like the idea of being able to cover it, since it's going to be an outdoor furnace. I'm not going to use it indoors. Down there I can put my blowers. I could still consider converting it to a gas furnace, but gas is expensive. Might as well get some use out of this stainless steel grill so we make it into a furnace, a blacksmith furnace. On today's vlog, I'll talk to you as soon as I figure out something to talk about. But I think I'll crank up my ride lawnmower and just drive the property. I haven't been out there all winter. No telling what I'm liable to come across out there that needs attention. Okay. That's going to be my blacksmith forge project. It might work and it might not, but it's something to tinker with. Another thing I'm going to do, I've got a fence post down there made out of a piece of railroad rail from back when I had a fence across the front of the property. And that's the only part of the fence that's still left. It was a gate post. solid piece of railroad iron, or railroad track, about 5 or 6 feet long, mounted in cement. I'm going to have to dig it up, bring it up here and use it from my anvil. I'd be the only person in the world with a 6 foot railroad anvil. Let's go fire up my mower and pick up some tree limbs or something. I know I got some limbs need picking up. Let's go do the limbs first. Y'all realize I could have hooked up my trailer to this mower, come out here and pick up these limbs and probably get more in the trailer than I would on them, laying them across my feet here, but I'm too lazy. Most of them just having fun tinkering around with my video camera, making a video. It is a pretty day in Georgia. I must have picked up 1,000 of these limbs the other day when I was clearing the property. Riding around out here on my mower picking up these limbs reminds me of a story I could tell you about. Well, not actually a story, just something to talk about. I showed you a video yesterday when I first went to work for the railroad shortly after I got out of the Navy. And when I went to work out there, put us on the repair track. Well, we had to learn how to operate machinery that I had never operated before. In fact, I wasn't too handy with driving a stick shift car I had learned on an automatic. I told one of the old men, I don't know how to drive that. Get on there and learn, boy. Got all day, ain't you? You're getting paid by the dang hour. Get up there and learn. And that's how I learned how to drive lots of things. Forklifts, mobile cranes, tricycle cranes, the big rubber tire devices. I even once got up on a flat car, cranked up an army tank, and drove that back up on the flat car where it had slid off the end. Get up there and learn, boy. One time, one of them big old international harvesters, like they drive around harvesting wheat with, and corn, and big old harvester machines, big as my building over there, come off a flat car. I got up there and found where the key was hid behind the battery, cranked it up, and drove it back up there. Got pretty confident on every bit of machinery they had out there to drive. We had more than one incident where might have got a little carried away. One time I was pulling with a galleon crane that had a chain hooked up to a pulpwood car. A bracket or grab iron on one corner was bent, and he just hooked a chain to it and said, pull on it. Well, the pulpwood car was jacked up on two jacks, and I didn't think about that. And I was pulling a little off center, and when I pulled on it, I pulled a whole cotton picking pulpwood car off the jacks. It fell out there on the ground by track four. We real quick got the boom high up in the air and tied some chains around the coupler and picked that booger bear back up and put the jacks back under it before the boss found out about it. We used to use forklifts for everything. That's why I'm using my machinery here to, my mower here to pick up limbs. It's just easier to do that with. You can ride while walk. Let's go drive the property. By Jove, there's something I might can use on my forge, blacksmith forge. Look at that hunk of iron. Yes sirree, we might be able to put that to some genuine use. Let's drive it down by the garage. That is a hunk of iron I probably hoarded 20 years ago. What other kind of iron we got up here? Got some angle iron. I don't know where to come looking when I need some angle iron and bricks. Probably no telling what kind of iron I got in that barn. The roof's coming down on it. Hadn't been in that barn in 5 years. talking a little bit a while ago about learning from some of the old men. I learned more from some of the old car knockers than I ever learned in training school. Most of them are gone, by the way, passed on to the hereafter. But I got some fond memories of some of them old men. Taught me a lot. Taught me how to get through my 40 years with a railroad, or darn near 40. Learned a lot by listening to those old men. Things like, we had a couple lot of air hoses. Especially if you were working an air job and putting a train together, you had a couple hundreds of air hoses. Well, you got to step in between the box cars to couple them air hoses, and we couple them in a live track. Never know when they're going to start moving some of that stuff. Anyway, one of the first things I learned was when you step across that rail in between them cars, you only put one foot in there. You kneel down on one knee, couple that air hose. If the car starts to move, you've already got half your body outside the rail. You just shift your weight to the rear and jump back, and you're out of there in the slightest little move of that box car. That's just one example of many things I've learned on the railroad. They taught us how to get up and ride on trains, which is illegal now. Sure saved a lot of walking though. I think I picked up enough limbs for today, even found something to use on my grill.